Hey, my name is Alex Weinert. I'm the director of identity security for Microsoft. And what that means is that for every account that Microsoft has, we're trying to keep you safe from unauthorized access and fraud. And, you know, so that puts us right in the middle of the battle in terms of trying to keep accounts safe. And there is probably no team in the world that dislikes passwords more than my team, as we deal with passwords getting broken all the time. And so what I want to talk about is one of the things that I work on a bunch at Microsoft is helping with our overall zero trust strategy. And when we look at zero trust, you know, we think of zero trust as really anchoring on these three principles of verify explicitly, assert least privileged access, and then assume breach, right? And passwords are, you know, in this sort of verify explicitly, one of the most important things is make sure you've got strong identity, and passwords make it very difficult to get strong identity. And I'm going to talk to you about some of the examples of why. Now, you know, if you've heard me talk about this before, like I tend to get very geeky, very technical, but I'm going to take this in a little bit of a different direction today. And I want to tell you a story in terms of an old children's story that we have. And this story plays out in lots of different cultures with different flavors, but it's the story of the three little pigs. And the story of the three little pigs, if you're not familiar with it, goes like this. There's these three brothers, and they all go off to find their way in the world. And each of them has to figure out how to shelter themselves and be safe from the big, bad wolf that's roving the land. And, you know, the youngest sort of least wise brother goes off, and he's a little lazy. He goes off and builds a house out of straw. And that house is weak, but it's quick to build. The, you know, middle brother, a little bit smarter, a little bit more industrious, goes and takes that straw house concept and steps it up and builds a house out of twigs. And that stick-built house is a lot stronger than the straw house, but still not perfect. And it's still vulnerable to some attacks. And the wisest, you know, most forward-thinking, you know, most sort of zero-trust-focused brother goes off and builds their house out of brick, right? And the third little pig builds his house out of brick, and that house is very strong and very beautiful. And that's going to be our framework for talking about passwordless and why we don't use passwords as sort of a major part of any zero trust strategy. And so we'll start out here talking about the youngest brother, right? We're going to talk about the house of straw. Now, the house of straw, the young pig goes off and he builds his house of straw, and that's passwords. And passwords are pretty easy. You know, we're all used to passwords. Most systems have passwords built into by default. I don't have to argue with my users about using passwords. But man, when the big bad wolf comes, and in the story, the big bad wolf comes and he huffs and he puffs and he blows the house down. When the big bad wolf comes, boy, if he wants to knock down the straw house, there sure are a lot of good options, right? The big bad wolf can just guess passwords. Most users will pick the same passwords, and their passwords like 123456 or password 123 or QWERTY IOUP. And these passwords are all about things that you can remember as a user. Unfortunately, people anthropologically are very similar, and they all pick the same passwords. Now, you might have, you know, really cool rules in your organization like uppercase, lowercase, numbers in a special. That's a very common pattern. And what that does is guarantees that the first letter of that password is in uppercase, the next couple letters are lowercase, there's four numbers, two to four numbers, and an exclamation mark at the end. Because those rules reliably make passwords easier, not harder to guess. And so password spray gets like 1% of accounts can be broken in any given organization with just 10 different passwords being tried. The attackers know what's common. Good news is that in Azure AD, we do too, and we can protect you from some of that, but it's still the number one way that we see accounts break in the wild is password guessing. Password replay is where, you know, you have a user who's got a super clever password, maybe they're doing something super smart, and they, you know, they think up their magic password, and then they use that password at work, and they use it on, you know, each of the social media sites, and they use it with us, and they use it everywhere else. And then password replay becomes another really major way. So if I break any given system, like if I have a breach at some major social media site, I can try all the usernames and passwords from there, and the chances are really, really good that I'm going to find that some of those passwords are being used on other sites as well. And so that's the second major way we see this go down. And then phishing. The funny thing about, you know, passwords is to a great extent, it's a secret that the human knows, which means it's a secret that the human can disclose. And so phishing is where I either trick you or simply ask you, hey, you know, please log into this site. I promise you there's a funny video here. It's a cat in a kitchen, like falling off a counter. It's super cool. You got to see it. And the chances are excellent that even with warnings, you will click through and enter that page and then just type your password. Now, if that's not enough, we have social engineering. And really, honestly, we've seen cases where all the attacker did was say, hey, I'm with support. Would you send me your password? And the response from the user is, sure, I'll send you the password, right? We have cases where, you know, very commonly malware can get onto a machine. It can either scrape passwords as you're typing or, again, can intercept those passwords as they go onto the wire. And so malware is another mechanism. And then brute forcing, where, you know, somebody gets hold of a database or just tries over and over and over guessing different passwords if they're targeting a certain person. And you do need to worry, are the people that you're using, are the various places where you're storing passwords, are they storing those passwords securely, right? Like, they could be storing them in plain text or with simple hashes that are unsalted. And all of these things are things that make passwords really vulnerable. So that house of straw is gonna come down. And if you're wondering, okay, sure, this is theoretical, you know, especially these three on the left, guessing, replay, and phishing, right? These three attacks, we think, all right, you know, theoretical, maybe there's some wolves, maybe there's some not. But I want to let you know that so far this month, we have already blocked 3 billion password attacks. And that's not a particularly unusual month, right? So when we look at attacks coming from all over the world, people are attacking accounts from all over the world. And these are all in that set of categories. So either password guessing, right? Phishing attacks or replay attacks. And so lots and lots of wolves out there doing lots of huffing and puffing, and the straw house will come down. And the thing is, if we look inside the straw house, we like think, okay, now the house is down and we can kind of look inside in that pile of straw. What did we see? Well, it was never really a fair game for users, right? The password is a mechanism, you know, especially as the systems became more prevalent with attacks. The passwords are hard to choose. It's hard to, you know, what's a cool password that nobody else is using that I can remember, right? Super, super hard to do. Every site you go to has different rules about passwords. And as a result, what we see is that help desk costs are super, super high. And then in an effort to lower those help desk costs, people create new holes, and help desk becomes yet another way to break accounts. So the house of straw was never gonna stand. And in the face of all these attacks, we know that the house of straw is no good. And so we've been pushing super hard to say, please enable MFA, right? I even wear a shirt, enable MFA, because MFA is the stick build house. And when we say MFA, we're saying is you type in the password and then there's a second gesture, right? So now you're in the house of sticks. Like, multi-factor authentication of any kind is infinitely better than passwords only. And so we strongly encourage use of MFA at least. But even multi-factor auth, especially if used as it commonly is with telephony, with phones, like your mobile phone, is really, really vulnerable to things like SIM jacking and OTP phishing, right? And this is where an attacker doesn't stop with saying, hey, what's your password? But they say, and punch in the code on your phone too, please. And recently, things like Modlishka toolkits have come up that actually make it easier and easier to put a machine in the middle and trick a user into going to visit a different machine that looks exactly like the site that they think they're trying to log into. So here you send them a link, they click on a link, and what the link does is it basically says, I'm gonna look exactly like the app to the user, and I'm gonna look exactly like the user to the app. And all the thing in the middle is doing is just replaying the UI on each side of the equation, right? So this is real-time phishing or OTP phishing or MFA phishing, and it can break accounts as well. And with tools like Modlishka checked in, it becomes easier for people to do that. And so even the stick-built house, as much better as it is than the straw-built house, has some real vulnerabilities. And when we go look inside the stick-built house after that house collapses, right, what we're gonna see is that, you know, users don't really want to register their personal phone numbers, their personal email addresses, right? They don't like it when they get challenged to get, you know, enter a code into the UI. The costs are higher for, you know, both the person who's paying for the phone calls, but also for the person who is dealing with the help desk and the issue around that. And so we have adoption problems such that in the industry as a whole, we measure this every single day we look. And right now we're sitting at just above 20% of users in our enterprise environments are actually using MFA, which is way below the 100% we want, right? Now in Microsoft account, we push MFA a lot harder and our numbers are much, much higher. But the truth is that use of MFA on the regular, as a regular normal thing, is still a place where organizations face resistance from the business and users get some friction as well. And so we want to do better, right? We want to do much better. So we see even the twig built house, as much stronger as it is in straw, it has some issues. So we can go on and we can say, all right, what about the House of Bricks, right? And the House of Bricks, what's super cool about this is we can see, like, the big bad wolf can come and they can huff and puff with every single attack. I mean, they can come in and they can do, you know, password guessing, they can do password phishing, they can do, you know, OTP phishing, they can do, you know, machine, like, they can do all these different things, machine in the middle, all of it. And with a good cryptographically strong solution, we get to a place where, in fact, all the attacks we know about, right, all the attacks we know about will fail in a House of Bricks. And that's a huge deal, right? So unlike, you know, passwords where attacks evolve past the password, or telephony where the phone was really never designed to be the, you know, secure channel to carry, you know, codes, but we made it work that way. The thing that's super cool about the passwordless solutions is that they were designed from the beginning to address modern usability and modern attack landscapes, right? And so as a result, all of the attacks we know about right now will not work. Now, I want to clarify something. When we say passwordless, right, we don't just mean doesn't use a password. Like, there's old techniques that you can sign in without typing an actual password. When we went on this journey, we wanted to make sure that we created this tuple of fantastic usability and great security. So when we say passwordless, every passwordless solution we're talking about is cryptographically secure, and every one of them has got intrinsic multi-factor authentication. So there's no, you know, clear text secrets, there's no QWERTY IOUP, there's nothing to store that's a risk in the server, you know, or on the wire. Like, it's, this is a secure channel, and the usability is fantastic, and it's intrinsically multi-factor. So, you know, you have the phone that's in your hand, that's something you have, and maybe your fingerprint that unlocks it, that's something you are. In Windows Hello, same thing, you have the device plus, you know, your face that's unlocking it. A FIDO token, same thing. We can take the FIDO token, and then there's a digital unlock there, either something you know or something you are that unlocks that. So all of these solutions are intrinsically multi-factor, and they're, from a protocol level, they're secure. They're as good as we know how to make them, and as a result, none of the known attacks that are common for breaking accounts, like, again, 6 billion deflected attacks so far in this month, right, would work against the House of Bricks, would work against these passwordless solutions. And now I want to be careful, because I'm a security geek, and security geeks will tell you that there's no such thing as provable security, right? You know what you know, and then, you know, we see what we see in the wild. But right now, you know, what we can say is that pretty much with passwordless solutions, you're forcing the attacker to go to in-person, one-at-a-time attacks that require a lot of proximity, and that's a lot of cost. The old joke, thanks to XKCD, is the joke about the $5 wrench, right? Is that, you know, no matter how good your crypto is, if you eventually coerce the person who really is the account owner into signing in for you, you know, you may have a problem. But short of that, man, passwordless is spectacular in terms of its current security profile. And we're measuring, you know, we're watching, but we're seeing, you know, there's just, you know, essentially no known exploits right now. And, you know, the thing that's really cool is we go look inside that House of Brick, right? What we see is that, you know, older, wiser pig, right? The wolf came huffing and puffing, but he didn't blow the house down. You know, that pig is living with, you know, they're watching the game on the big TV and enjoying, you know, waiting for the pizza to arrive and just having a good old time and focused on their productivity or on their digital life rather than being focused on how to protect themselves against all these wacky attacks. And better yet, for them to sign in, they just look at their machine or touch it, right? It's super easy, so they don't have to worry too much about it. And when the pizza comes to the door, right? And this last part is really important, because that phishing attack, that OTP phishing attack, is really, you know, pernicious and sneaky, right? When that wolf comes to the door, this house has a built-in doorbell camera. And the doorbell camera can go and make sure that the person coming to the door is the right person. And if it's the big bad wolf looking down the other side of that camera, right, you know not to open the door. And what's one of the many cool things about the protocols that are involved in these passwordless solutions is they have something called verifier impersonation resistance. So, like, Windows Hello and FIDO have this built in. And what it is it's like our doorbell camera. It makes sure that the person we're talking to, the person we're issuing the creds to, is the right person and is not the big bad wolf pretending to be the pizza boy. And so as a result, The system is even more secure. And again, you can focus on a great productivity experience, you know, and enjoying your digital life and not worrying so much about how do you manage to remember the passwords or keep your phone current or all the other things that come along with relying on older mechanisms to sign into your accounts.